More Entrainiacs. You see that? This is like last few rides of the year.
Sick.
So when I originally set up my new Canyon gravel bike, I ended up setting it up with basically my old clunker road shoes with old Shimano road shoe pedals, just clip-ins. I didn't really think anything of it.
Apparently that's not right.
So I went on the first few group rides with these shoes and these road shoe pedals, and people were saying, are you still using road shoes? And it was to the point that even the Shimano guys that I work with were like, are you using road shoes gravel riding? I'm like, yeah, what else do you use? Of course, because biking is a never-ending money pit, there are gravel shoes that exist. Like, it's not enough that we have multiple different pairs of road shoes. We now have to have gravel shoes with gravel cleats. Now, personally, I couldn't care less if you are going to use road shoes or gravel shoes with proper cleats. Like, if you're riding, it's all a win. But I started researching why gravel shoes even exist when they look very similar to road shoes. And what I found is that if you do really want to commit to gravel riding and get a proper setup that is going to be as maintenance-free as possible, as stable as possible, as good a riding experience as possible, you might want to switch over. So I'm going to give you some options for what the best gravel pedals are, because they're very different. So let's first start with, why is it a big deal to use road pedals on your gravel bike instead of actual gravel or mountain bike pedals? Well, it's not a big deal. Use them if you want. But one of the main things is that you can see with road pedals that, with road pedals that they're only one-sided. So as you hop onto the bike, which you have to go on and off the bike a lot, like there's a little bit of putting the bike on your shoulder when you're on gravel. There's a lot of stepping down just to stabilize yourself, a heck of a lot more than on road biking, where basically you clip in your front door and then you might not clip out as long as you don't have to pee for like miles and miles. But with road pedals, you have just the one side, the one platform. If it's upside down, you're not gonna be able to clip in like that. And then the second thing has to do with the shoe. With this road pedal, it's designed to be held like nicely and stiffly in place, and it's designed to basically stay like that. This is not designed for walking around. This is not designed for putting your foot down. Like I said, there's a lot of clipping out, putting your foot down in gravel and mountain bike riding a lot more than in road riding. So when you're putting your foot down on this, it's pretty unstable. As I was doing this a few weeks ago in gravel situations, like everyone was walking around and I was slipping and kind of like almost rolling ankles one way or another. Whereas gravel pedals, here, let's see if we can zoom in on this at all. The cleat actually sits inside in the middle of these two platforms on the outside. So when you're walking around, you've got an entire platform to go on. The cleat is hidden there in the middle. And you are gonna need probably new shoes, because most road pedals are a 3-bolt system and gravel pedals are a 2-bolt system. So now that the pedals are off that thing, let's wait for the sun to come up and we'll head off to the bike shop. See what they recommend. Because I've read a lot about this, but I wanna hear it from them. I'm intending to just get pedals, but I know that that's never how it happens. I'm gonna walk out of there with a lot of stuff, always. Ended up getting here is the Shimano Deore XT. This is a higher end
Shimano SPD model. That's what you're looking for.
We got pedals. Let me explain.
So what you're looking for is essentially just a more basic mountain bike pedal. Now, the reason that you're looking for a more mountain bike pedal is because, as you can see, there's a lot more clearance inside all this. So that means that debris is going to actually filter through here a lot easier. Also, this is two-sided, so you can go any which way. It doesn't matter which way you end up clipping into this, that it'll actually work. So that's gonna make it easier for how many times you go on and off. If you do end up getting a gravel shoe like this, it's more than likely that it's gonna have a two-bolt system. So these pedal clip-ins are actually, that right there is the clip that you're gonna put on your shoe. That big three-bolt clip, definitely not gonna work for that.
So whatever pedals you're looking for essentially a mountain bike pedal. In the Shimano lineup, you're looking for the PD, SPD, not the road SPD, the PD, the mountain bike version of it. Looks like this. Another option that a lot of mountain bikers use is crank brothers, typically known as egg beaters. Now I've got egg beaters on my fat tire bike and they're really, really basic, but they're really, really floppy. You can get them with platforms around the SPD pedal. Whether you want egg beaters or not, I don't know. They're decent. They're not a huge amount of money. They're pretty basic. They look kind of cool. But I don't know. I have used them before and just not a big fan. They're a little too floppy for me. If you like look pedals, you can go with the Look X-Track race pedals. These are double-sided, but because there's not the same clearance that you get in these Shimano pedals, they're also, they're more prone to clogging up because all of the tolerances in here are a little more, bit more tight. There are the Ritchie Brothers Comp XC pedals, and I just kind of stay away from that just simply for the standpoint that Shimano is gonna be a lot easier to find parts for. Ritchie, yeah, good bike company, great pedals, but they're just not there and they're harder to find. Some people choose to have a platform around this or just go with outright platform shoes. That tends to be for more real serious mountain biking where you're clipping in and out, but even real serious mountain bikers don't use platforms a whole lot. Or you could get the big platform that is a double-sided, basically it's this pedal, but with a platform. I just like something a little bit lighter and sleeker because I'm not doing mountain bike riding, I'm doing gravel riding where weight and speed counts, just mentally. And then finally, some people do use the same clips that I use on my road bike, which is the Speed Play pedals. They're not two-sided. You can get a two-sided version, but I don't know. I've found them harder to clip into. I want something that's robust that I can clip in and out of, walk around with, no problem. So with all that jibber jabber out of the way, I'm sure A, you're tired of hearing from me, and B, I gotta actually put these on. Let me go for just a real brief ride after putting these on, and I'll let you know if it's even a different experience. I mean, besides walking around and clipping in and out, is it a different experience to have this for a ride? Am I gonna notice anything different? Drastically better to have gravel shoes and gravel pedals? No. Is it better and worthy of you putting it on a future purchase list? Yes. I'll explain why. So, like I said, walking around in these cleats as opposed to road cleats, way more stable. It's like just a pair of stiff shoes. That's much, much better. And then clipping in and clipping out of these, way easier. You know how when you first get a pair of clip-in shoes and you've got to kind of find the clip-in procedure, you've got to feel it out? I didn't have to feel it out once. You just kind of find it easily, and because the pedals are two-sided, you never have to look down and try to get your foot in. It just happens like right away. So that's significantly better. Now, is it so much better? I'd say that you are silly unless you're using a pair of gravel road shoes. No. No, I wouldn't worry about that. Put it on the list of things that you want to do because it is more stable. It is easier to clip in and out. If you are riding in cold weather like this, these were way better as far as keeping my feet warm compared to road shoes because the hard front keeps the wind out. They're just like marginally better at all of the things that you need them to be better at for gravel riding. As far as budget goes, what I would recommend is if you've got a real entry-level bike, talking about $50 to $70 US, if you have a mid-range bike and you want something a little bit nicer where the bearings are gonna be a little bit more smooth, the serviceability of these is gonna be a little bit easier, a little bit more reliable, you're looking at that $70 to $120 US. And if you're looking at like just matching your high-end bike, didn't make sense to put a cheaper pedal on. We're talking $120 and these were US, $120 US. So I'll put a link in the description below to all the pedals that I mentioned, the shoes that I've got. Some of those will be affiliate links. So if you click on those and buy anything from Amazon within the 24 hours after clicking on that, we do get a small kickback. It helps us just a few cents here and there. But if you don't want to do that and you aren't already subscribed, hit the subscribe button below. Later, Trainiacs.